Hello friends and welcome back to another video from my YouTube channel, that is Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. So your friend Vipin Sharma is currently available on India's largest learning platform, that is Unacademy. So you can follow me on Unacademy by clicking on the link given in the description below, and you can watch all the lectures made by me on Unacademy's learning platform. आप लोग Unacademy की app भी download कर सकते हैं from Google Play Store for better learning experience. So I hope that you have gone through your homework very well. Last lesson में मैंने आपको कुछ homework बताया था. I hope आपने कर लिया होगा. So let's proceed in the lecture series of genetics. So this is going to be the first conceptual lecture of genetics, that is the laws of Mendel, the basics of laws of Mendel, that उन्होंने क्या-क्या experiment किए थे. Okay, so the experiments done by Mendel are known as the hybridization experiment, right? Hybridization experiment. And he have done all those experiment on simple garden pea. Okay, garden pea, that is Pisum sativum. Okay, how can you write it? Pisum with P capital because it is the generic name, and sativum with S small because it is the specific epithet. Since both of these words are handwritten, so they must be separately underlined. This type of nomenclature is known as binomial nomenclature given by Carolus Linnaeus. Okay, we have understood it in the chapter biological classification and in living world also, right? So baat karte hain kuch characters ki, that he have taken garden pea as the plant on which he want to work, and he has worked for 7 long years. So what are those 7 long years? 1956 to 1963, and this is quite important, this data is very important. And what is the date of birth of Mendel? 22nd of July 1922 itself. This is going to be the date and year of birth. So उन्होंने 7 long years के लिए काम किया था 1956 से लेके 1963 on garden pea. Why? Because garden pea has some sort of alternate characters which are known as contrasting characters. Okay, this term is very important, contrasting. Contrasting or alternating means just opposite, which can be visualized easily. Okay, there are some sort of things, there are some sort of characters which can be seen easily to differentiate between two plants. Okay, let's say about the most simple example, that is the stem height. If he have taken stem height as a character, to wahan par hamare paas do contrasting characters aate hain. Number one is tall. It means that we can easily identify tall plant, and the second one is dwarf. Okay, so if he has planted two plants of pea and he have grown them for the same time, and one is tall and one is dwarf, he can easily differentiate between the two. Ki bhai ek lamba hai, ek chota hai. And that contrasting character helps him to make a statistical analysis and the data to be interpreted very well. क्योंकि उनका जो डेटा है उसे संभाल के रखना और उसे यूटिलाइज करना बहुत ज्यादा जरूरी था. बिकॉज मेंडल, ग्रिगर जोहान मेंडल वॉज द फर्स्ट साइंटिस्ट ऑल्सो नोन एज द फादर ऑफ जेनेटिक्स हु हैव इन्वॉल्व्ड द मैथमेटिकल कैलकुलेशन इन द बायोलॉजी फॉर द वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम. मैथमेटिक्स की कैलकुलेशन और स्टेटिस्टिक्स को बायोलॉजी में लाने का जो काम था, जिम्मा था, वो सबसे पहले मेंडल साहब ने उठाया था. बिकॉज ही इज फ्रॉम मैथमेटिकल बैकग्राउंड बट ही वॉन्ट टू वर्क ऑन द प्रोसेस ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस. That's why he has done different kind of hybridization experiments also. Okay, so उन्होंने क्या किया? 7 different contrasting characters को पकड़ा. Now there is 2 terms which no one is going to tell you. What is the difference between character and what is the difference between trait? Okay, so from this particular table you can easily identify both of them. Let's say stem height. So stem height, from the name it is indicated that it is a kind of character. Stem height is a character, but tall is a trait which is possessed by a plant. Dwarf is a trait, right? So from a particular character a plant can only have one trait for one character. Okay, agar hum baat kare flower position ki, then a plant can be tall and having terminal kind of inflorescence. It may happen, right? सो टॉल एंड ड्वार्फ विच आर द अल्टरनेटिंग फॉर्म्स ऑफ अ कैरेक्टर आर नोन एज ट्रेट एंड द पर्टिकुलर थिंग अबाउट विच वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक इन अ प्लांट दैट इज द स्पेसिफाइड कैरेक्टर. सो दिस इज कैरेक्टर, दीज आर ट्रेट एंड आउट ऑफ दीज ट्रेट्स द वन इज गोइंग टू बी डोमिनेंट एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज गोइंग टू बी रिसेसिव. राइट, सो वॉट इज डोमिनेंट एंड वॉट इज रिसेसिव? इफ टू Let's say genes or alleles are present together, then the one which is going to express itself is going to be dominant. Let's say T जो है, okay, T जो है, it represents the tall plant and small t used to represent the dwarf plant. Okay, so when the plant combination is TT, it is obviously going to be tall. This condition is known. Capital T is tall. Then this is having two capital T, this from mother, this from father. We know about it very well, right? ऐसा ही होगा कि एक प्लांट से कैपिटल टी आएगा, दूसरे से कैपिटल टी आएगा, they will merge together and they will form a progeny TT, and this TT is going to be tall. In the next case, there is small t, there is no confusion that in capital T it is going to be tall, in small t it is going to be small. But when T present, it has 50% of the dwarf character, 50% of the tall character, but the plant is not of intermediate height. Plant कभी भी बीच की height का नहीं होता. The plant used to be tall. Why? Because this particular term T is highly dominant on small t. So the capital T will express itself, the small t will not. The small t can only express itself when it is present with another small t, because there is no alternative option, they have to express, right? But in some cases where capital T is present, even a single capital T is enough to induce the character or the trait of tallness in a plant, right? So यहां से वो पॉइंट आता है डोमिनेंट का. So if two different type of alleles or two different kind of, let's say, terms are present together, because you don't know now about the alleles or genes, so we will talk about it later. If two different alphabets are present together, so the alphabet that is going to, express itself is the dominant one, and the one whose expression is hidden or masked by the second one is recessive. This is the basic concept. Okay, so now let's talk about the different contrasting characters, about all the characters and their traits. एंड देर इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फॉर ग्रेजुएशन एग्जामिनेशन. जो ग्रेजुएशन के बाद जो एग्जाम होते हैं, सच एज IIT जैम एंड JNU CEE CUET, डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ एग्जामिनेशंस आर देयर. सो द क्वेश्चन यूज्ड टू बी आस्क्ड फ्रॉम ऑन व्हाट क्रोमोसोम दैट पर्टिकुलर कैरेक्टर इज प्रेजेंट. सो आई हैव एडेड अ लिटिल बिट ऑन इट, दिस कैन बी काउंटेड इन द एक्स्ट्रा NCERT लेक्चर, सो दैट यू कैन इजिली मेमोराइज कि किस क्रोमोसोम पे कौन सा कैरेक्टर प्रेजेंट होता है. एंड सम टाइम इट यूज्ड टू बी आस्क्ड इन NEET ऑल्सो, बट इन सम अदर फॉर्म, दैट हाउ मेनी कैरेक्टर्स आर प्रेजेंट इन क्रोमोसोम नंबर 4 और क्रोमोसोम नंबर 1. ओके, सो दिस काइंड ऑफ अरेंजमेंट इज गिवन बाय एस ब्लिस्ट. देयर इज अ साइंटिस्ट एस ब्लिस्ट, उन्होंने बताया था दैट सेवन ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कैरेक्टर्स, बिकॉज देर आर सेवन कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कैरेक्टर्स हियर, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, विच आर प्रेजेंट इन फोर डिफरेंट क्रोमोसोम्स, क्रोमोसोम नंबर 1, क्रोमोसोम नंबर 7, क्रोमोसोम नंबर 4 एंड क्रोमोसोम नंबर 5. दिस इज टोल्ड बाय एस ब्लिस्ट. ओके, बात करते हैं कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कैरेक्टर्स की. तो कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कैरेक्टर्स में पहला लेते हैं सीड शेप. इन मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस आर द डोमिनेंट वंस, राइट, व्हिच मे डोमिनेट, एंड द रिसेसिव वंस आर लेस इन नंबर, ऑब्वियसली बिकॉज द चांसेस ऑफ अ डोमिनेटिंग ट्रेट टू कम इज मोर, बिकॉज इट इज इन टू कंडीशंस, but recessive ones are less. So in most of the cases the seed is going to be round, so it is dominant. In some of the cases it is going to be wrinkled, so it is recessive. Let's talk about seed color. Now there is a misconception. There is a misconception that most of the seeds are green in color, but the dominating trait is yellow. Okay, so most of the seeds are yellow because it is dominating, and रेस्ट ऑफ देम आर रिसेसिव ग्रीन. सो ये बस याद करना है हमें, बाकी सारे याद हो जाएंगे, बाकी सारे यार इजी. फ्लावर कलर, सो देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ फ्लावर कलर्स, वन इज व्हाइट एंड द सेकेंड वन इज वायलेट. ऑब्वियसली वी कैन से दैट वाइट वन इज गोइंग टू बी द रिसेसिव एंड वायलेट वन विल बी द डोमिनेटिंग वन. आफ्टर दैट पॉड शेप, व्हाट इज पॉड, जिसके अंदर दाने प्रेजेंट होते हैं ऐसा कुछ होता है, दिस इज नोन एज पॉड. सो इट इज फुल, ओके, देयर इज नो रिजेस प्रेजेंट ओवर हियर, बट इन सम केसेस इट इज कॉन्स्ट्रक्टेड लाइक दिस, ओके, सो इट इज फुल एंड द रिसेसिव वन इज कॉन्स्ट्रक्टेड बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द पोर्ट्स आर फुल, राइट. नाउ पोर्ट कलर, व्हाट इज द कलर ऑफ दिस पोर्ट, इट इज यूजुअली ग्रीन. Now the pod color is used to green, it is dominant, but the seed color is going to be yellow when you talk about dominant one, right? So yahan par kya hoga, green pod color is the dominant one, yellow is the recessive one. Flower ki position ki agar baat kare ki flower violet is the dominant, but where it is going to be present, so there can be two type of arrangement. One is axial, that this is the plant, so it is present on the axis, and the second one is terminal, that it is present on the terminus. So the terminal position is recessive, it is not usually present, and the axial one is the dominant, okay. So ye aapko pata hona chahiye. Now the last character, last contrasting character that we have already talked about is the stem height, that the stem height will be easily distinguished, okay. The one is going to be very long and the one is going to be very short, that's obvious. So that kind of contrasting traits present in different kind of characters enabled Mendel sahab to give some laws, to give some rules of hybridization, jinhe kaha gaya Mendel laws or the laws of Mendel. So un laws ke bare mein detail mein study karenge after learning the monohybrid and dihybrid crosses, because these crosses forms the basis of those laws. To agar un laws ko padhna hai to monohybrid aur dihybrid crosses padhna bahut zaruri hai. So this is a basic lecture on what, the contrasting characters taken by Mendel, and these are some chromosomes, you have to note them down, ki yahan se question aane ke chances zyada hote hain. The seed shape character is present on chromosome number 7, the seed color is present on 1, okay, the flower color is present on 1, so the pod shape is on 4th. So I have made different kind of tricks for them which can only be memorized by me, because these are based on the incidents of my life. For example, when I was in 7th class, I bought a bat. Mere papa ne ek bat dilaya tha, and that bat jo hai uske upar SS likha hai, double S ke bat aate hai, kafi popular hai. So seed shape jo hai, maine aise yaad kiya tha. Then pod se related tha koi 4th pe. 4 se ye pod. So 4 means tetra. And we know about the class tetrapoda, right? So pod shape, that is tetrapoda, it means that pod shape is related to the chromosome number 4. So there are different kind of tricks made by me, and you can make your own tricks which are going to be very very effective. So I have learned all these 7 characters with their respective chromosomes in a particular fashion by making my own tricks. So agar aap bolenge to main apni wali bata dunga, otherwise aap log khud banaye to behtar rahega, kyunki ye jaise ki aap itni aasan se yaad nahi rakh payenge, because it is the incident that happened in my life, so I can memorize it very very effectively, right? So this is the basic lecture on how Mendel selected the pea plant. There are some important topics, that why he chose only pea plant, who is the first one to work on the pea plant, is it Mendel or someone else, or what are the reasons behind the success of Mendel. So ye jo sari cheeze hum short videos banakar iske alag se dalenge, because these videos, these questions are very important for board examinations point of view. So the students who are preparing for board examination can also watch them, right? And those questions are theoretical, which are not important from needs point of view. So usko hum thoda alag se dal denge, aaj hi dal denge is video ke baad. So stay tuned for that video. And if you really like this one and you got the concept, then do hit like button and subscribe to my channel. Apne doston ko mere channel ke bare mein bataiye aur support kijiye. Thank you so much and stay tuned.